Thank you. W7 live from Slinger Senior Night at Slinger, and a volleyball almost hit me right in the face. These girls, I tell you. Welcome to Slinger for tonight's North Shore Conference matchup between the West Bend East Lady Suns and the Slinger Lady Owls. I'm Gary Wickerman, live from Slinger. Along with me tonight, camera in tow, Dave Beasley. We'll be bringing you the photos that you'll see tomorrow live on W7, on our social media, W7. Welcome. Should be an interesting one tonight. Again, I don't have the standings up on a graphic, but I can let you know kind of what they look like as we head into the last week of the season in the North Shore. Good news and bad news for both of these teams. The bad news is that Hartford's already taken care of business and won the conference. So congratulations to the Hartford Orioles in locking down their second conference title in 3 years and their second ever. So, second ever and second in 3 years. So Coach Klink has got that program on the move. Here, Slinger coming in tonight, 5 wins and 3 losses, a really tough loss Thursday night to Whitefish Bay. Whitefish Bay is also, I believe they're 5-2. I'm still pulling this up here. But one thing I can tell you is in the past, if you thought, okay, West Bend East, check the box, it's a win. Not this year. East having a really nice season this year, coming in 5 wins and 3 losses in the North Shore and looking to take over third place with a win tonight over the aforementioned Lady Owls. We're still a few minutes away from National Anthem starting lineups. The it's senior night, so festivities ran a little bit long, but we're in pretty good shape. Quick break, once again, W7, as always, powered by Jolly Good Soda. Jolly Good Soda powering the W7 Nation. Quick break, message from Jolly Good. You're watching W7.
Jolly Good Soda. We put the pop in Wisconsin.
So let me give you the full standings now that I've got it in front of me. Hartford, as we mentioned, 8-0. Whitefish Bay, 6-2. Slinger and West Bend East are both 5-3. The winner tonight will have sole possession of third place in the North Shore, and a loss by Whitefish Bay tonight, and we'd have they'd be in a tie for second. Port Washington's 4-3. West Bend West is 4-4. Nicolet 3-5, Grafton 2-5, Cedarburg 2-6, and Homestead 0-8. That is your North Shore Conference Girls Volleyball standings. This has been the W7 live pregame show powered by Jolly Good Soda. Quick break, we're coming back shortly. National Anthem starting lineups. You're watching W7 Live powered by Jolly Good Soda. Senior night tonight at Slinger. Here are your seniors, your 2022 seniors for the Slinger Lady Owls. Number 5, Maddie Metke. Number 4, Emerson Swaney. Number 8, Emerson Alton. Number 9, Kaziah Barrett. Number 10, Maddie Gerleski. Number 11, Molly Noel. And number 12, Caitlin Pankow. A lot of seniors on this squad, 6 seniors. Swaney, Metke, Alton, Barrett, Gerleski, Noel, and Pankow. Those are your seniors. 3 minutes away from National Anthem starting lineups. Reminder, coming up November 6th, it is our girls basketball schedule reveal show. We do it once a year. It is probably our most watched event of any year is the girls basketball schedule reveal show. We're going to go through our entire girls basketball schedule for 22-23. That's on Sunday, November 6th. Our first game of the year is November 15th, and that is Laconia versus Oostburg, live from Oostburg on Tuesday, November 15th, 7:15 start. Defending state runner-up Laconia coming in to take on the young guns of the Oostburg Lady Dutch. You can watch it live on W7, November 15th at 7:15. One last plug. Thursday night is our girls volleyball finale for the 2022 season. We will be at Kewaskum for Kettle Marine Lutheran at Kewaskum. And pretty much like almost every event of the past 2 weeks, the winner gets a big prize. This year, the winner will get the East Central Conference Championship. KML and Kewaskum fighting for that conference title. We'll bring it to you live, 6:45 first serve on Thursday, live from Kewaskum. Looking forward to it. One more quick break. You're watching W7.
Jolly Good Soda. We put the pop in Wisconsin.
There your national anthem, the starting lineup. It's another first. I love coming to the gym because something new happens every time, no matter where you go. And what I saw tonight was just really fantastic. I'll touch on it here in a minute. We are underway. You're looking at Skycam. This is Kim right behind me, about 35 feet up in the air. Nice cross-section view of the playing floor. We'll use that one, plus we have three others that we'll work with tonight. First point goes to Western East, that is Billy Dandall, 6'1 senior. This is the one you're probably most used to. Serving for East is number 8. Maya Howe is one of the captains. 9 seniors on this West End East team. 9. Coach Barnes is gonna have her hands full next year. There's gonna be a whole new crew next year. 2-0 East. Tip and point. Well, we know you're out there watching tonight. Senior fans and West End East fans, tell us where you're watching from and who you're watching. Put it in the comments on YouTube, and we'll mention it to the kids. They love to know that you're watching them and that you're supporting them. So put that in the comments, and we'll pass it along. 3-0 East. Vandal again on the serve. Nice touch, nice job by our senior, recognizing West End East kids, and we're thrilled to be here as always. 5-2 East. Serving for the Suns is Paige Harder, one of the captains on this team. I'm actually related to Jayla Harder, I bet she is. Jayla Harder, of course, from Random Lake, pretty close proximity wise. I bet you there's a relation there, but maybe ask Paige later. All out here watching, you can tell me. 5-3. That one's out. 6-3 Suns. Good start for East. Kate Wiedmeyer to serve. Emerson Alton in for the Lady Owls. And serving will be number 1, Ella Conan, the freshman. Four freshmen on the varsity team for Slinger. And that one over the half. And 6-5. Conan is 1. Gabrielle Graff for the 2nd. Allie Beers, you'll hear her name a lot. And Miley Quade. I'm sorry, I didn't play the tickets. Quad A, I believe. I like Quade. That's why I call it Quade. I like that. Okay, I think it's actually Quad A, I believe. Quad A. Okay. as Anna Noel tuck it in from lacrosse. Awesome little assist play. Molly. 7-5. Must been East in the first set. I'm sure the Molly Noel fan club will be out in full force tonight, as I was last time we were here. Good swing, but good up for East. That was Alton on the swing for Okay, these are beers, not Molly beers. 8-5 East. Now serving Peyton Schmidt. Oh, Allie Beers, sneaky Allie, sneaky, 8-6. There's Molly Noel in the serve, number 11. We'll get a camera back there, about the first time out. I'll just give you a chance with the cutting line. And that one into the net, 9-6. East. Ooh. Ellie Beers on the slide. I'll tell you what, she is special. She is really special. Get her and Malia Johnson. Get Malia Johnson back next year. Allie is a sophomore, Malia is a senior. It'll be tough to beat in D2 next year, I'll tell you that right now. Good luck. 10-7 East. From my way too early predictions for 2023 North Shore Champions, I'm the pet swinger at the top. Just saying. They're going to lose some good players this year, though. Down the line, got it. Emerson Swaney in. Her dad came up to me pregame and said, how do you get to this live stream thing? But we weren't live yet. And I said, hey, as soon as it comes up, it'll pop up. So hopefully, Mr. Swaney, you're watching. Officer Swaney, you're watching tonight. 10-8. Up. Lily Bandel on the kill, 11-8. And Maya Howe, the third. That's good. Play. Quarter, Maddie Gillespie that time. 11-9. Connor checking in from Green Bay, also known as Mr. Du Bois. Lauren also watching from lacrosse, supporting the Slinger Girls. That's court, and that is a point for. And of course, our buddy Ashlyn Ham, aka Ashlyn Hammy, checking in from Carroll. Slinger alum. And Ashlyn, we're going to be at Carroll on November 8th when the women's basketball team opens their season against MSOE. So if you're at the basketball game, pop over to her. 12-9 East. Out. 13-9. Paige harder to serve. Shovel and Wiedmeyer on the block. 14-9 East. Connor says, check the text. Guess what, Connor? First, I gotta charge my phone because, as usual, it is dead. That one's deep. 3 hours, 14-10. I believe Matty Metke to serve. I believe it's going to be West End Town, and it is 15-10. Beers is blocked. Brianna Shovel on the block, 16-10. East. Post archive with the timeout. This is the rhythm. You're watching W7, powered by Dolly Gatoy.
In Wisconsin.
Sixteen-10 in favor of West Bend East on the first set. An ace, Kate Wiedmeyer, makes it 17-10. Tell you what, great first set here for East tonight. Blocked! Wiedmeyer again. Back corner, out, 17-11. Emerson Alton back in, 17-11 West Bend East. Slinger got some work to do in this first set. Wow, Allie Beers, hello. Seventeen, 12. How Beers just crushed that thing. I hope she plays basketball this year. I really hope she plays basketball. Play multiple sports, girls. You only get 4 years. That's it. Then it's over. I don't care what your clubs tell you. They don't know. They had their time. Every one of those club leaders had their time playing high school sports. This is your time, not theirs. Not anybody's. It's just yours. You decide what you want. You want to play just one sport for 4 years? Do it. But if you want to play multiple sports, don't let anybody tell you you can't. 18-13. Not referencing anything in particular, just saying in general, there is pressure in all sports to give all your attention to one sport. Don't do that if you don't want to. You get four turns around the block, and that's it. That's all you get. Then it's over. And guess what? You never forget it. And it never comes back. I still dream about going to basketball practice. I've been out of basketball 31 years. Still dream about it. You don't dream about your conference championships and your big wins. You dream about the relationships with those buddies that you had and the special time that it was. And that's what you think about. At least that's what I do. 19-14. Great serve. Molly Noel on the serve. That one is out. Courtney Curley, check it in. Court, was that senior night at Hartford tonight? ...19-15. Now 19-16. Sorry I missed you tonight, Courtney. And that went into the net. We were at Hartford last week, and Court was in school, wasn't able to be here, but she's back now and for senior night. 20-16. Got a lot of offers to come places tonight. Winnebago Lutheran wanted us to come out. Hartford, of course. But I couldn't miss Slinger senior night. Speaking of, Emerson Alton, hello. 20-17. Rye, hope you're watching tonight. ...20-17 in the first set. Wow, great swing and point. That is Maya Haug, the captain. 21-17. As I said, volleyball is kind of like the NBA. Doesn't count until you get to 20. It's kind of like the last 3 minutes of an NBA game. No point in watching the Bucks until there's 3 minutes left of the game. Then you'll know who's going to win or not. 22-17 East. Bucks could be up 33 points in the third quarter. And 3 minutes left, down by four. Great tip. Gerleski, 22-18. Watching from Chile. I love it. I love our international viewers. And point. East 2 points away from taking set one. Haley Groff. W7 favorites and alum. Hope you're doing well, kiddo. 23-19. Sister Batty, freshman on this team. What do you think, Haley? Is she going to be as good as you were? She's pretty good, right? 23-19. Oh, that may have been out. Point East. Set point for West Bend East. Lucia Breyer. Those Breyers, I tell you. 24-19 blocked. Tell you what, Wiedmeyer's had a fantastic first set of the front row. Slinger trying to stay alive in this first set. Free ball for East. Set. Wiedmeyer on the slide. Back corner and out. 24-20. Right on cue, Haley. Gabby in to serve. Groff on the serve. Good days, Gabby. Oh, Can't let that one go. 25-20, East takes set one. You're watching W7 Live, powered by Jolly Good Soda.
Jolly Good Soda. We put the pop in Wisconsin.
W7 Live, welcome back. Set two. Set one goes to the Lady Suns. Can the Orioles fight for the Orioles? See, can the Owls fight back and take set two? Courtney, that's on you. Courtney Curley. Tough first set for Slinger. Tell you what, star of that first set, no question, was 11 and 14, Wiedmeier and Schauble. They were fantastic. Here we go. Scoreboard back up. And Lady Owls get the first point. Emerson Alton back in for Slinger. And 2-0. That one is out. 3-0, Lady Owls. Ah. And that one is out, 3-1. Miley Quaid in for Slinger. And point 16, Lily Bandle. 4-2, Slinger. Wow, great job. Peyton Schmidt on the kill, 4-3. And now Paige Harder on the serve. Schmidt again, good up. And Slinger's lead, just like that, is gone, 4-4. Harder to serve, one of the captains on this team, Harder and Maya Haug are your two captains. That one's out. Everybody a little deep on those serves so far in the second set, 5-4, Slinger. Senior night at Slinger, 2022. Emerson Sweeney, Maddie Metke, Emerson Alton, Molly Noel, and Caitlin Pankow are your Slinger seniors. Class of 2023. Great save by Gerleski. Uh-oh, not going to get that one. And it's 5-5. Malia Johnson back in. 13. She's worth the price of admission just to watch her play. Holy cow. Cross court and point. I know Coach Vetterkind has been careful with Malia's playing time just due to some things, some physical things, but glad to see her back in. 6-5. Slinger. Malia, number 13. Outside hitter. Six, five Lady Owls in the second set. East won the first one, 25-20. Slide step and point, Allie Beers. Glad to see you, Ella. 7-5. Slinger by two, watching from South Carolina. All right, that's nice. And now 8-5, Slinger up. Johnson, Quaid on the over. Boy, Slinger doing a lot of running for volleyball, I'll tell you that. Hard to get in system that way. Set, Beers, blocked. Let's see what the call is. Point, West Bend East. 8-6. And I think we've got a review going on right now. Here's the other thing I like about volleyball. I'll explain here in just a second. It's something I really, really like that I wish other sports would do because I think it's a really, really great idea. Volleyball does some things really well. Two things that I really love about volleyball. Number one, you get the kids involved. They're officials. They help out. They retrieve volleyballs. I mean, they have to set up and tear down. They take the nets down. They put the nets up. They do a lot of work, a lot more than pretty much any other sport, I think. I think more is required of you to be a volleyball player, at least, around helping the program physically than with any other sport. So with that said, there's one other thing that I really like that volleyball does. And that one is out. 9-7. The thing that they do that I really love is if there's a disputed call on the floor, the captain of the team disputed the call has to go talk to the official, not the coach. I like that a lot. I'd like to see football take that on. I'd like to see basketball take that on. If you got a problem with a call, your captain goes and talks about it with the official. And coaches aren't allowed to interact with officials as far as disputing calls. I think that's a great idea. I'd love to see the WIA adopt that across all sports. I think it does two things. One is I think it helps reduce the official-coach tension and just the optics with that. That's number one. Number two, the more important thing, is it gives leadership skills to the girls. You got to go up and make an argument. So just being a captain is more than just a popularity contest. You've got to be able to make an argument. You've got to be able to advocate for your team. You've got to be able to explain the facts. Those are skills that are going to help them later in life. So kudos, volleyball. You guys are doing it right. 10-8, just one man's opinion. Bristol Beamborn on the serve. Dad Chuck is a good friend of ours, good supporter of W7. Appreciate it, Chuck. Hope you're enjoying the broadcast tonight if you're watching, or watching later anyway. Point East. 10-9. Bristol will go again. Another good one. Ace the first time. Must get that from mom, right, Chuck? Those athletic skills. And now we've got another dispute going. Got a little indecision, and it's going to be Slinger Point, 11-9. Emerson Alton back in for Slinger. Wow. Great up. Beautiful. Slide step, and Alton on the dig that time. Everybody getting involved. Ooh, thought that one might have been out. Great rally going here. Who wins it? West Bend East. Eleven-10. View from our sky cam. Right behind me and about 30 feet above me. Beamborn on the set. Look out. Emerson Alton. Hey, Matt Chuck. 12-10. Slinger. Hey, go Suns, my friend. I'll actually be at the Slinger West Bend East football game Friday night. Wow, nice swing. Not live streaming, of course, but be there to watch that. And point for East. I'll tell you what, 16, Lily Bandle got some power on that swing. 12-11. Blocked. Brianna Schaubel, and we're tied at 12. I asked Chuck where Bristol got her athletic skills. He said definitely from mom. Good up. Set. Slide and block, but out and point. Slinger, 13-12. Maddie Metke to serve. Blocked. Allie Beers on the block. 14-12. Slinger up two. Block but out. Malia Johnson back in. 14-13. Serving for East is Kate Wiedmeyer. Great serve by Kate. Beers gets it over, and it is 15-13 Slinger. East won the first set 25-20. There's one other trend in girls volleyball that's catching on that I really, really, really like. And I'm starting to see it more and more, and I'm loving what I'm seeing. That one out of the net. And that is, I love seeing the girls going away from the spandex shorts and wearing the long leggings. I think, number one, I think it's a really cool look. I think it's a really athletic, cool look. Number two, just as a dad of three daughters, that's a better look, I think. I don't need to alliterate the reasons why. You know the reasons why. I just prefer that look. I think it's more athletic, and I think it's just a better look for the girls. I'd like to see more of that. Plus, they just look cool. I think it's got a really cool, sleek look to it. 17-14. Groff on the serve. And again, I know I'm an old fuddy-duddy, an old, you know, old dude, out of touch, out of the times. But you know what? I spent a lot of time with teenagers. And I think I somewhat keep in touch with what's going on. And I just like that look better. I think it's a better look. 17-15 Slinger. So I'd love to see more of it. Oh, great serve. Johnson on the save. Oh, Malia Johnson! 18-15. Any way you can get her, right, Malia? And she comes back out again. Here's the thing with Malia that you got to know. There's only so much you can protect her from because she can only play one way, and that is, you know, with her hair on fire 1,000,000%. She can't play safe. And, you know, you got to watch out for this, watch out for that. She can only play the way she plays. And it's one of those, I don't think you'd want it any other way. So the coaches are careful with her just to, again, want to make sure, of course, you're protecting the player first and foremost. Here's Ms. Beanborn again. Ah, Chuck, you jinxed her, man. Get back to football practice. Stop watching. 19-16. Slinger by three. Alton back in and Johnson back in. Slinger by three in the second set. This one's going to be out. I'll tell you what, I've retrieved about eight volleyballs tonight. 19-17. I need like an assistant over here that just gets the volleyballs for me. Nobody's volunteered for that job. Not that I can blame them. Oh, great up. Beautiful. Great job. Bristol, you redeemed yourself there. Point goes to Slinger, but Bristol Beamborn, just great hustle. Went and dug it out of the bench and kept the team alive, but Slinger gets the point, 20-17. Substitution for Slinger. Miley Quaid back in. Lady Owls. 21-17. And I believe East is going to call timeout. You're watching W7 Live, presented by and powered by Jolly Good Soda.
Jolly Good Soda. We put the pop in Wisconsin.
Slinger by four in the second set. West Bend East won the first one, 25-20. Lady Owls trying to even things up. One each on senior night at Slinger. Great serve, ace. Maybe, no. Point, Slinger, Groff on the serve. Nope, bigger part, that is 10. Maddie Gerluski on the serve. And now Slinger 3 points away from taking set two. Wow, with authority, Lily Bandel. 22-18. And now 23-18, Slinger, 2 points to go. Beers back in. Ace, and now it's set point for Slinger. 24-18. Point, West Bend East, 24-19. Set for Beers on the slide, blocked. Point East, great block by seven. Peyton Schmidt, 24-20. Kate Wiedmeyer on the serve. And point Slinger, set Slinger, 1-1. You're watching Slinger Girls Volleyball on W7 Live.
Jolly Good Soda. We put the pop in Wisconsin.
Set three, and look who I found. It is Ellie Zagel from Slinger. Elle, how you doing?
I'm doing good.
Glad to have you on.
Yeah, thank you for letting me.
Ellie came over to say hi, and I kind of roped her in to say, come and hang out, and let's talk. We'll talk about a lot of different things. 1-1 is the score in this one set each as we go to the third set. West Bend East won the first one 25-20. Slinger the second one 25-20.
It's been an exciting game so far.
Well, you know, I said at the beginning of the broadcast, it's one of the, it's, you know, over the years it's been, well, West Bend, there's a win. It's not really that way anymore. They, you know, certainly in volleyball, having a really nice year, 5-3 in the North Shore, and looking to take down the Lady Owls tonight. We'll see.
Hopefully not.
Hopefully not. That's right.
It's senior night, so all the seniors were super excited today at school.
I bet.
And they were posting on Snapchat.
I bet. Well, I put a post up saying, you know, there's 0% chance of me missing Emerson's senior night.
I
wouldn't miss that. I'll tell you what, I had a lot of people say, can you come and do our game? I'm like, I've already told Emerson I'm coming. So if you want to call her and let her know I won't be there, you can deal with that. But I'm not going to be the one to do that.
I would not want to be there.
So Emerson expected me to be here. By gosh, I'm going to be here. 2-1 Slinger in the third set.
Oh, that was good.
So how was golf?
I was good. It was kind of an up and down season for all of us.
Yeah.
The end of
Emma had a nice season.
Yeah, she did. She did really good at state She ended up with a 37 on the front nine, and we were all like, oh my gosh.
Amazing.
Yeah.
She's something else. Where's she going to school? Do you know?
I don't know, but I don't think she's going for golf.
You think she's done, huh?
Yeah, I think so.
But, you know, golf is kind of one of those cool sports that you can always use it, right? I mean,
you can
teach your kids how to play. I mean, you can play. It's not like softball where you're going to go play all the time, or volleyball. You know, it's not like that. I mean, basketball, even. You go play in a rec league. But, I mean, you know, go take your kids on a Saturday afternoon and go play basketball. I mean, you go play golf.
Yeah.
Plus, you get to drive the whole cart thing, and you get to have beverages. I mean, they don't bring around, you know, beer carts for basketball games. At least no games I've ever been to. 3-3. So let's see, Ms. Zagel. Let's see, you're golf, basketball, and track, right?
Yes.
What do you do in track?
So during the high school season, I do hurdles and jumps, and then I also do track during the summer, so AAU, and I do the heptathlon.
I saw that. what place did you get in the heptathlon? I saw that that post the other day.
Yeah, I got fourth.
Fourth?
Yeah, it was a really good day. Or 2 days, I guess.
I mean, that's being an athlete. I mean, it's one thing to be a great volleyball player or a great, you know, basketball player, but to do a heptathlon. So what are all the events? Can you name them all off? All right, let's hear them. What are
they? Sometimes I struggle. So it's over 2 days. So the first day, it's 100-meter hurdles, and then high jump, shot put, and the 200-meter dash. And then the second day, it's a long jump, javelin, and the 800, which is the 800 is the killer.
I was going to say that they should put the 800 first. I mean, that's like punishment at the end.
Yeah, it's definitely whoever has the most grit to keep going.
Well, I'd definitely put you in that category. And then snowmobile in the wintertime, right?
Not anymore because of basketball.
Oh, yeah, with basketball, that's probably out this year, huh?
Yeah.
How's it going with Coach Hugh?
It's going good. We had open gym.
He's a good dude, isn't he?
Yeah, he's really, really nice.
Yeah.
He jokes around with all of us.
He
so
does.
Much.
He, you know, I like him a lot because he's one of those guys, one of those coaches that gets it, right? That understands girl sports. I mean, a lot of times you get coaches that just move from boy sports to girl sports. They coach them the same. You can't do that.
No.
And Coach Hugh is one of those guys that understands the mental part of it, the fun part of it with girls' sports.
He had us play kickball one time at an open gym this
That
year.
Sounds about right.
It was fun.
That sounds about right. Now, you guys don't play Pewaukee this year, do you, in basketball?
Nope.
That'd be a fun one.
We played them in fall ball, and they had 25 people, and we had six.
Ouch.
It was not fun.
Well, they got a pretty good program over there.
Yeah, they do.
Coach Reuter's got that going on.
Yeah.
How are you guys going to be in basketball this year, you think?
I think we have a chance. It's definitely going to be hard losing all those seniors.
Yes.
So we really only have, four or five people returning onto varsity. Otherwise, everyone else is new.
I hope you've been lifting and working out because you're going to have to do a lot of rebounding this year.
Yeah. Yeah. I started going to a CrossFit place that.
That's good.
Reagan Paul from Cedarburg.
Reagan Paul, sure.
Yeah. She's a beast.
Yes, she is a beast. I think she just got offered at Maryville, if I remember right, in St. Louis area.
Okay, that's what the guy was telling me. He was talking about her in St. Louis or in Missouri or somewhere.
Yeah, Max Etheridge is the assistant coach from Maryville. He actually lived at the Monona Grove area. He coached at Monona Grove, and so he knows a lot of Wisconsin high school girls. He did games with us. I mean, I've known him a long time. So he's heavily recruiting Wisconsin kids. Shea Kelly being one of them from Brookies. Annika Plemer from Brookies. She's going there. Reagan got offered there. So I told Max, I'm like, you gotta save some of the kids for Wisconsin schools, man. You can't take them all.
That's right.
He absolutely is, which is great. I mean, it's more opportunities for the kids, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
8-7. Ellie Zagel, our special guest on the broadcast from Slinger. 27 days from basketball.
Ugh, nerve-wracking but exciting.
And this is our last week of volleyball. We got tonight and then Thursday at Kewaskum, and that'll do it. I'll tell you what, 16 Bandol from East.
She
Does she play basketball?
I do not know.
I don't think she does. She should. I don't think she does, but she should.
I saw before her and Allie both run around to the right side and hit down, and both of them did it, and it looked so cool.
What do you think? Is Allie Beers going to play basketball?
I don't know.
Allie, yes, you have to play.
I hope she does.
Tell her I said she has to. It's a requirement. And I get so she listens to me before the Sting or whatever the club is that she's in.
Yeah.
Come and play basketball, Allie. At least for a year. It'll be fun.
Yeah, I hope 9'8".
She, she is such a great athlete, isn't she?
Yeah, she's can jump for higher than I've ever seen.
Tell me your favorite Emerson Alton story. You've got to have one.
Emerson Alton?
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
We could be here all night, I'm sure.
I don't even know. I don't know. I haven't had many classes with her lately, so.
She is one of a kind, I will tell you that.
My boyfriend and my boyfriend.
You're not allowed
mom.
To have a boyfriend, Ellie.
Oh, yeah, I know. My dad doesn't like it.
I'm sure he doesn't.
He calls it a friend or a boy that's a friend.
So he's in denial, basically.
But
hey, so, you know what? Most of us dads are.
Yeah, true.
My daughter is going to have her first two kids
in
December, and I still call him her friend. My son-in-law. 11-8. Yeah, so twin girls, believe it or not, in December.
That's
so
exciting. That's so exciting.
Yeah.
My golf coach just had a granddaughter. So we were all celebrating that.
Fantastic. Yep, my first grandkids. I'm getting old, I'll tell you what.
It's all good. Gotta 11-9.
That's why I hang out with you guys, though.
I don't think you're old, though.
Thank you.
Bring the young spirit.
That's right. Bring the energy, right?
Yes.
Tell you, you know who I wish would have played basketball would have been Malia Johnson.
Yeah, me
oh
too.
Oh, my gosh. That kid is athletic.
Yes, I remember.
But, I mean, she's a heck of a volleyball player.
Yeah.
I mean, just unreal.
I feel so bad for her this year with her shoulder.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been a rough year.
Yeah.
12-9. There is a volleyball match going on, I guess. Blocked.
Well, that was good.
By Bandle.
Emerson. Yes.
Emerson Alton. 12-10. Now, I got to talk about the most controversial subject of the year at Slinger. Are you ready for this?
Oh, goodness. The wall.
The wall.
The wall.
What are your thoughts on the wall?
I do not like the wall.
The wall is reserved for Game of Thrones, and that's it.
Yeah,
come
literally.
On, Daniels.
I don't know why we built it, but I hear from the cheerleaders all the time that it's so annoying because there's no ventilation. Into, like, the mezzanine, like, there's nothing.
Well, they probably do this so they can sweat the wrestlers out
yes,
and have them lose
true.
Weight for
That's
wrestling meets.
That's actually a good point. Probably.
You know, you guys have a pretty darn good wrestling program
yes.
here.
Yeah,
and
we
so
do.
I know that they've been a lot of investments in it. So I just give Daniels a hard time because I have to give Daniels a hard time.
Oh, that was a good.
He is one of the best, though. You guys are so
yeah.
lucky to have Mike. He's so fantastic.
He always goes through the hallways naming everyone by name.
Of course he does. He
yeah.
knows everybody.
And it's really good to have someone like that.
Yes, yes. And tell you what, he's been so great to us. He kind of lets us have our run of the place. Although I did give him a hard time about the Mez. I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm gonna miss calling basketball games from up there. I'm not gonna do that.
You got like the balcony seats that no one else gets.
I know.
In.
I tried doing a volleyball match up there earlier
yeah,
this year.
Yeah, I remember
year.
That.
Yeah. It was okay.
Yeah, it's hard because you can't see. You got that little
3x3
window that you're trying to.
Why not make a whole window all the way across?
Oh, that would have been
see,
good.
That's what I think. I mean, at Slinger, you guys got tons of money. It's not a money issue. At Slinger, you guys are just flush with cash.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Take it out of the Daniels slush fund. 13-11. Oh, great job. That's 7, Peyton Schmidt. And it's 14-12, West Bend East. So, we're going to do several Slinger games this year. We'll come over and see you guys, and I'm sure we'll be here for senior night. In fact, you can count on it. I'll be here for senior night. I wouldn't miss your senior night.
I don't even know when. I don't – okay. Apparently, a lot of our games are on Thursdays this
I
year.
Love that.
So
do that
I.
means we can do a lot more of them.
Sweet. I think that is so much better.
I do, too.
Because Friday, then you can have like a – Not easy you, practice.
You can, but then you can go watch games, too. You
yes.
can go watch your
yes.
upcoming opponents.
Because
you can come and do a W7 game with me.
Oh, yeah. We never get to do stuff like that. Like, wait. Okay. The one. I don't think we've ever actually gone and watched another team play. But I know teams have come watch us. So.
So you'll come and do a couple games with me this winter, huh?
I'll try.
She'll try. Yeah. She's really busy.
I'll have to work on my sports commentating skills.
I'm going to let you get back to your friends. Ellie Zagel has been our guest on W7. Let me ask you one question, Ellie. You ready?
Yeah.
Everything W7 does, it is.
For the girls.
We'll be right back.
Thank you.
third set, West Bend East. It's one set, it's 1-1, and it's going into the third set. Tell you what, you really got to give it to East tonight, playing super, super well. And big thanks to Ellie Zagel. She really just came over to say hi, and I kind of roped her into hanging out and talking with us for a while. And that's, again, I know we got off subject to volleyball and on to other things, Ellie's things, which, you know, that's what this is all about. It's about the girls. When we say it's for the girls, it has to be. This is part of the reason I come out and do these games is because I enjoy being with the kids. I enjoy having the kids come on the broadcast. I like that the kids are comfortable coming over and saying hello and seeing me. And that's why I'm here. So I know it's great and we do all this great stuff and it's all selfless. It isn't. I love being around the kids. 16-13 in the third set. Into the net, Peyton Schmidt, and it's 16-14. Slinger trying to climb back into this thing. And I believe we've got a violation on East, and that point will go to Slinger. It's now 16-15. Wow, opposite corner, but out. And Slinger has tied it up 4 in a row for the Lady Owls, 16-16. Woo. There's some heat on that one from Schmidt, 17-16 East. Malia Johnson back in for the Lady Owls. Out. 17-17. This is a huge set for Slinger. They have to have this one. Cannot go down 2-1. Emerson Alton back in. Once again, the odds of me getting home early tonight are slim and none, and Slim just left the building, I believe. Ace! 18-17, Slinger. That's Molly Knoll on the serve. Great set. Eighteen. Alton blocked. Blocked again. And point. You know, the funny thing about time is that really does go by so fast. The last time we did a Slinger West Bend East game, it was Riley Alton on the floor. Riley now long since graduated. I want to say class of 19, I believe, if I remember right. Now little sis Emerson, class of 23, a senior. And senior night at Slinger. And the Lady Owls have a two-point lead, 20-18. Big point here. And it goes to the Lady Owls. It's a three-point lead for Slinger, 21-18. Can they close this one out and take a 2-1 lead? Great swing and point. Maya Haug, 21-19. Trouble on the serve. Johnson. Blocked, but point. Miley Quaid. Allie Beer is back in, 22-19. And a block for Beers, 23-19, 2 points away from a 2-1 lead. That one's out. Unforced errors, they hurt you. 23-20. Bristol Beamborn to serve. Great serve. Boy, she's got a nice serve. And set. And point, Slinger, set point, Lady Owls. Bristol Junior on this team. It's all juniors and seniors on this West Bend East team. I think we got a discussion going on here. We're going to fix the antenna. I think it kind of slid out of place a little bit. Coach Vetterkind. Using a reach to get that corrected. Set point for Slinger, 24-20. And here we go. Alton on the serve. Johnson on the dig, set, swing, point, set, Slinger. Miley Quaid closes it out, 25-20. Slinger takes a 2-1 lead. You're watching West Bend East Girls Volleyball on W7 Live.
If you don't know W7, you don't know Notre Dame girls basketball. I'm Georgia Gregory, and W7 is for the girls.
W7's got it right. Covering girls' high school sports all the time. 100% free, 100% live. W7 for the girls.
If you don't know W7, you don't know Find a Girls Basketball. W7 is for the girls.
If you don't know W7, you don't know Germantown Girls Volleyball. I'm Lauren Sitter.
I'm Abby Liker.
And W7 is for the girls.
Fourth set, 2-1 in favor of Slinger. And West Bend East to serve. Bristol Beamborn on the serve. Nice dig. Blocked by Alton, partially blocked. Now Emerson on the swing. And point Slinger. Emerson Alton to serve. Woo, that thing came down fast. Slide step. And into the net, tied at one. Molly Noel in. Maya Haug on the serve for West Bend East. Beers is blocked, but point Slinger. 2-1 Lady Owls. Reminder, Thursday night, we will be at Kewaskum. It is our season finale for volleyball. Back corner, point, Allie Beers. Three-one Slinger. :45 start time on Thursday, Kettle Moraine Lutheran at Kewaskum on W7 Live. I'm not for sure. My guess is it's going to be senior night at Kewaskum. We'll see. And now 3-2. Bandle on the serve, point, Slinger. Four-two, Lady Owls. Maddie Betke in for Slinger. That one's deep, I believe. East calling for a touch, and it's out. Point Slinger, 5-2. Malia Johnson back in for Slinger. 5-3, Slinger in the fourth set. Great serve. Wiedmeier. And point for East, it's 5-4. Oh, into the net. I jinxed her the last time. I should have said that. And now it is 5-5, or 6-4, Slinger. Emerson Alton back in for Slinger. Emerson Alton, 7-4 Owls. Eight-4 Slinger. In the fourth set. Just out. 8-5. Reminder, following tonight's game, we will have the Jolly Good Soda player of the match. You want to stick around for that. And another unforced error by East. Peyton Schmidt that time, and it's 9-5 Slinger. Two big errors so far for East in this fourth set. That's 2 points. They handed the Slinger. It's a 4-point lead. Can't do that. Got to execute here. East needs a point. Hit the antenna. 10-5 Slinger. Things not going Westbed East way right now. Coach Barnes going to let him try and play through it. Into the net, 10-6. The serving has been far from crisp tonight, I would say. A little spotty. Brianna Schaubel on the serve. That's a nice one. Johnson on the receive. Tell you what, Miley Quaid gets the shoe game for tonight, I'll tell you that. And now 10-7. You can see those things from quite a ways away. There's no missing Miley. Shoe game is on point. And that one goes to Slinger, 11-7. Allie Beers back in. In the middle. Hanging out, getting ready. Bandle on the point. Lily Bandle makes it 11-8. You'll notice Malia Johnson playing the libero position tonight. That's just, she's just such a great athlete. I mean, she can literally play anywhere. I mean, you can stick her anywhere. Obviously, they prefer to have her in the front row, but, you know, that's where she is. 13-8 Slinger. That one's out. And now 13-9. Alton comes out. And Molly Noel back in. Peyton Schmidt in for West Bend East. Maya Haug on the serve. Just skipped over. Just the way she wanted it. 13-10. Look out. And point for East. Now three in a row for East. 13-11. One more. Coach Vetterkind may ask for a timeout. We'll see. Into the net. Again, unforced errors. That's the theme of the night. I think this one's going to come down to who makes the least of them. Gabby Groff in to serve. Down the line, but out. ...14-12. Bandle will serve. 14-12. And again, into the net. Wow. That is four in this set for West Bend East. And not coincidentally, it's a three-point lead for Slinger. 15-12. Blocked. Ellie Conan on the set. That one is in. 15-12, 15-13, make it. Wiedmeier on the serve. Point Slinger. Gerleski that time. 16-13. Out. 17-13. Slinger closing in. East is going to make a run. They better do it now. Down four. 17-13. In the fourth set. Ace. 18-13. Coach Barnes again letting them play through it. And it's funny because each time I thought she'd probably take a timeout, she let it go one more, and the serve has been out on both occasions. So clearly she knows what she's doing. Not that she did validation for me, but 18-14, the overture, so to speak. I guess that's 18-12. Never mind. My bad. 18-15. It's been a long week. Love from Eau Claire from Samantha. Another Slinger alum. 18-16. And now a timeout, Slinger. You're watching W7 Live. Eighteen-17. Point for East while you were away. Had to go fix the camera. Alton, cross court, point. Emerson Alton. 19-17. Miley Quaid back in. Gerleski on the serve. Big one here. Johnson, Quaid. Miley gets it back over. Free ball here for East. Out. And now 20-17.21-17, Slinger 4 points away, now three away, 22-17. Lady Owls feeling it. Senior night at Slinger. Gerleski again to serve. That one's out, 22-18. Nice job, though, by Maddie. Bree Schaubel to serve. Out. Five missed serves. And it's a five-point lead, 23-18. Slinger trying to close this thing out at four. Blocked, and now it is match point for Slinger, 24-18. Stay tuned, coming up, Jolly Good Soda player of the match. And point for East, 24-19. Malia Johnson back in for Slinger. Bristol Beanborn on the serve. slide, swing, point, match, Slinger, 25-19. They take set 4, 3-1, Lady Owls. You've been watching North Shore Conference Volleyball on W7. We'll be back with our Jolly Good Soda Player of the Match. Don't go anywhere, whatever you do. W7, we are back with our Jolly Good Soda player of the match. It is Molly Noel from Slinger. Nice job, Molly.
Thank you.
Sometimes winning volleyball games isn't about doing all the right things. It's about making the least amount of mistakes. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I guess.
And I think you guys did that tonight. You know, it probably wasn't your best game, but, you know, senior night's always kind of weird and kind of different. There's a lot of emotions going and things like that. But, you know, when you guys had opportunities, you took advantage of them and beat a really good West Bend East team.
Yeah.
What do you like about this group, Molly?
I love our team chemistry. I love that we can just have fun. And when we're kind of down and we have low energy, we just find a way to bring it back up. And it's so nice. Like, it's so fun to be playing with these girls. I don't know. I don't know what else to say.
It was really emotional at senior night tonight. I mean, any tears?
Yeah. I mean, I'm going to be losing all my best friends. So, like, I don't know. This is most of my time is spent here. So,
That's hard, isn't it? I mean, but you're enjoying the journey, right? I mean, and you guys want to keep playing, right?
Yeah.
So I know you'll do that. Let's see. Let me ask a few questions here. Give me your best Emerson Alton story.
Oh, gosh. I don't know if she wants me to say this.
You better say it.
But we were
playing my ear real quick.
We were playing with some
Oh, yeah. No, don't share that one.
Come on, I'm just going to say it.
Okay.
So we were playing West Bend West last year, and everyone was cheering Cheetah. And as soon as she got, like, a really nice kill, she just flipped off the student section. And it was so amazing. It was so great. It was just a power move.
Why did I ask? Why did I ask the question?
It was so funny. Our coach wasn't too happy, but it was good.
I will tell you, Molly, we've actually started up what we call the Molly Noel fan club because the number of people that watch the match are like, go Molly Noel, go Molly Noel, go Molly. Your sister was watching tonight from lacrosse. Samantha from Eau Claire.
Oh, Sam Robarg.
Robarg, she was watching. So, I mean, you know, we got Ellie Zagel on here on the broadcast for a while tonight, so we just had a lot of fun. It's been, you guys, it's really been a pleasure getting to know you guys, and, you know, senior night's hard for all of us, right? Say goodbye to a lot of good friends, but here's one thing I want you all to remember, is that, you know, regardless of after the season, whenever it ends, you know, you guys are all part of the W7 family, and what that means is, and I really am very sincere when I say this, what it means is if we can ever do anything to help you, you just got to call me or DM me or whatever and let me know, okay? We're here for you guys always because this whole thing is about you guys. So thank you for the last 4 years. I wish you guys the best of luck the rest of this season and into the postseason, and I'm sure I'll see you at graduation. We'll probably be live streaming your graduation again this year, so we'll be doing that. Let me ask y'all one last question. Are you guys ready?
Yes!
Now, Emerson, make sure you make it to graduation, okay? Molly Noel.
I would put what I did to the
wedding. Molly Noel is our Jolly Good Soda player of the match. Molly and Lady Owls, look right there and answer this question. Everything W7 does, we do.
For the girls!
See you Thursday night in Kewaskum. Have a great rest of your night.